Pancakes.
Pancakes.
Kikiriki.
A rooster crowed.
Jack woke up and thought, I want a pancake. Jack said to his mother, can I have a pancake?
You can help me make it, said his mother. First, we need some flour.
Cut some wheat, please.
Then, take it to the mill to grind into flour. So Jack cut the wheat. Then, he went to the miller. Jack asked him to grind the wheat. First, they had to beat the grain from the wheat. Now, we will grind the grain to make flour, said the miller. Jack helped the miller to make the flour. Then, he took the flour home.
Can we make a pancake? Asked Jack.
Now, we need an egg, said his mother. So Jack got an egg from the hen house.
Can we make a pancake? Asked Jack.
Now, we need some milk, said his mother. So Jack milked the cow.
Can we make a pancake? Asked Jack.
Now we need some butter, said his mother. So Jack churned some butter.
Can we make a pancake? Asked Jack.
Now we need to make a fire, said his mother. So Jack got some firewood.
Can we make a pancake? Asked Jack.
Now we need some jam, said his mother. So Jack got some strawberry jam.
Can we make a pancake? Asked Jack.
Yes, said his mother. So Jack and his mother mixed everything in a bowl. They put some butter in a hot pan.
Jack, now put some batter in the pan, said his mother. Jack's mother cooked the pancake.
Then she flipped it.
The pancake flew up high.
It landed in the pan.
Jack's mother put the pancake on a plate and gave it to Jack.
Jack said, Mama, I know what to do now.
Polar Bear, Polar Bear, What Do You Hear? By Bill Martin Jr. and Eric Carle. Polar Bear, Polar Bear, what do you hear?
I hear a lion roaring by in my ear.
Lion, lion, what do you hear?
I hear a hippopotamus snorting in my ear.
Hippopotamus, hippopotamus, what do you hear?
I hear a flamingo fluttering in my ear.
Flamingo, flamingo, what do you hear?
I hear a zebra braying in my ear.
Zebra, zebra, what do you hear?
I hear a boa constrictor hissing in my ear.
Boa constrictor, boa constrictor, what do you hear?
I hear an elephant trumpeting in my ear.
Elephant, elephant, what do you hear?
I hear a leopard snarling in my ear.
Leopard, leopard, what do you hear?
I hear a peacock yelping in my ear.
Peacock, peacock, what do you hear?
I hear a walrus bellowing in my ear.
Walrus, walrus, what do you hear?
I hear a zookeeper whistling in my ear. Zookeeper, zookeeper, what do you hear? I hear children growling like a polar bear, roaring like a lion, snorting like a hippopotamus, flutting like a flamingo, braying like a zebra, hissing like a boa constrictor, trumpeting like an elephant, snarling like a leopard, yelping like a peacock, bellowing like a walrus. That's what I hear. What does polar bear hear? Panda bear, what do you see? By Bill Martin Jr. and Eric Carle. Panda bear, what do you see? I see a bald eagle soaring by me. Bald eagle, what do you see? I see a water buffalo charging at me. Water buffalo, what do you see? I see a spider monkey swinging by me. Spider monkey, what do you see? I see a green sea turtle swimming by me. Green sea turtle, what do you see? I see a macaroni penguin strutting by me. Macaroni penguin, what do you see? I see a sea lion splashing by me. Sea lion, what do you see? I see a red wolf sneaking by me. Red wolf, what do you see? I see a whooping crane flying by me. Whooping crane, what do you see? I see a black panther strolling by me. Black panther, what do you see? I see a dreaming child watching over me. Dreaming child, what do you... I see a panda bear, a bald eagle, a water buffalo, a spider monkey, a green sea turtle, a macaroni penguin, a sea lion, a red wolf, a whooping crane, and a black panther, all wild and free. That's what I see. What do panda bears see? Read this book and find for yourself and find out. Very Hungry Caterpillars First Fall by Eric Carle. As summer heat fades, as cool weather blows in, ready for fall? Let the season begin. A forest of green turns red, orange, and gold. See the leaves dazzle so bright and so bold. It's time to explore. Want to get out and play? Don't forget a warm sweater to keep cozy all day. Collect prickly pine cones. Catch leaves in the air. As they fall and land softly,
their trees become bare. Hear the wind whoosh, branches shake, rustling. Quiet critters scurry, building homes, bustling. Squirrels search for acorns, gathering nuts to eat. Then they stop. What's that smell? Surely something sweet. Pies hot from the oven. Hooray! They're all done. Apple, pumpkin, and pecan. Try a bit of each one. Those treats were delicious. Care to bake another batch? Instead, let's take a trip to the pumpkin patch. See silly scarecrows climb hay bales stacked high. Fall days are the best when friends are nearby.
Today, I'll be reading The Very Hungry Caterpillar by Eric Carle. In the light of the moon, a little egg lay on a leaf. One Sunday morning, the warm sun came up and pop! Out of the egg came a tiny and very hungry caterpillar. He started to look for some food. On Monday, he ate through one apple, but he was still hungry. On Tuesday, he ate through two pears, but he was still hungry. On Wednesday, he ate through three plums, but he was still hungry. On Thursday, he ate through four strawberries, but he was still hungry. On Friday, he ate through five oranges, but he was still hungry. On Saturday, he ate through one piece of chocolate cake, one ice cream cone, one pickle, one slice of Swiss cheese, one slice of salami, one lollipop, one piece of cherry pie, one sausage, one cupcake, and one slice of watermelon. That night, he had a stomach ache. The next day was Sunday again. The caterpillar ate through one nice green leaf, and after that, he felt much better. Now he wasn't hungry anymore, and he wasn't a little caterpillar anymore. He was a big, fat caterpillar. He built a small house called a cocoon around himself. He stayed inside for more than 2 weeks. Then he nibbled a hole in the cocoon, pushed his way out, and he was a beautiful butterfly.
Ten Little Rubber Ducks. Chuckity, chuckity, chuck goes the rubber duck machine. Out pop little yellow rubber ducks, one after another, one after another. The little rubber ducks are painted, bills red and eyes blue. Then they are packed, 10 in a box, and off they go to be loaded onto a cargo ship. "Hello," calls the captain. The captain and his cargo ship are taking the little rubber ducks across the wide sea to faraway countries, to faraway countries. Suddenly, a storm churns the water into big waves. A strong wind whistles across the sea, whistles across the sea. A big wave lifts up one of the boxes and throws it into the water. The box opens, and 10 little rubber ducks fall out. Ten rubber ducks overboard," shouts the captain. 10 rubber ducks overboard. After some time, the storm calms down. The 10 little rubber ducks bob in the big wide sea. As far as one can see, only water and sky. Water and sky. The 10 little rubber ducks begin to drift apart. The first little rubber duck drifts west. The second little rubber duck drifts east. The third little rubber duck drifts north. The fourth little rubber duck drifts south. The fifth little rubber duck drifts to the left. The sixth little rubber duck drifts to the right. The seventh little rubber duck drifts up. The eighth little rubber duck drifts down. The ninth little rubber duck drifts this way. A whale sings to it. The tenth little rubber duck drifts that way, bobbing and floating on the big wide sea. Sun is setting. It is getting dark. As far as one can see, only water and sky, water and sky. The next morning, the 10th little rubber duck meets a mother duck and her ducklings. "Quack," she says, mother duck. "Quack, quack, quack," says the duckling. At the end of the day, the sun sets again. It is getting dark. The mother duck and her ducklings swim towards their nest. The little rubber duck floats along with them. "Good night," says the moon. "Quack," says the mother duck. "Quack, quack, quack," says the duckling. "Squeak," says the little rubber duck. The Tiny Seed. It is autumn. A strong wind is blowing. It blows flower seeds high in the air and carries them far across the land. One of the seeds is tiny. It is smaller than any of the others. Will it be able to keep up with the others? And where are they all going? One of the seeds flies higher than the others. Up, up it goes. It flies too high, and the sun's hot rays burn it. But the tiny seed sails on with the others. Another seed lands on a tall and icy mountain. The ice never melts, and the seed cannot grow. The rest of the seeds fly on, but the tiny seed does not go as fast as the others. Now they fly over the ocean. One seed falls into the ocean. The others sail on with the wind, but the tiny seed does not go as high as the others. One seed drifts down onto the desert. It is hot and dry, and the seed cannot grow. Now,
The tiny seed is flying very low, but the wind pushes it on with the others. Finally, the wind stops, and the seeds fall gently down on the ground. A bird comes by and eats one seed. The tiny seed is not eaten. It is so small that the bird does not see it. Now it is winter. After their long trip, the seeds settle down. They look as if they are going to sleep in the earth. Snow falls and covers them like a soft white blanket. A hungry mouse that lives in the ground eats a seed for his lunch. But the tiny seed lies very still and the mouse does not see it. Now it is spring. After a few months, the snow has melted. Birds fly by. The sun shines, rain falls. The seeds grow so round and full, they start to burst open. Now they are plants. First, they send roots down into the earth. Then, their stems and leaves begin to grow up towards the sun. There is another plant that grows much faster than the new little plant. It is a big fat weed. And it takes all the sunlight and the rain away from the one of the small new plants. The tiny seed has not begun to grow yet. It will be too late. Hurry! But finally, it too starts to grow into a plant. The warm weather also brings children out to play. They too have been waiting for springtime. One child does not see the plant and he runs along and, oh no, he breaks one. Now it cannot grow anymore. The tiny plant that grew from the tiny seed is growing fast, but its neighbor grows even faster. Before the tiny plant has 3 leaves, the other plant has 7. And look, a bud. And now even a flower. But what is happening? First, there are footsteps, then a shadow, then a hand reaches down and breaks off the flower. A boy has picked the flower to give to a friend. It is summer. Now, the tiny plant from the tiny seed is all alone. It grows on and on. The sun shines on it, and the rain waters it. It has many leaves. It grows taller and taller. It is taller than the people. It is taller than the trees. It is taller than the houses. And now, the flower grows on it. People come from far and near to look at this flower. It is the tallest flower they have ever seen. All summer long, the birds and bees and butterflies come visiting. They have never seen such a big and beautiful flower. Now it is autumn again. The days grow shorter, the nights grow cooler. The wind carries yellow and red leaves past the flower. Some petals drop from the giant flower. They sail along with the bright leaves over the land and down to the ground. The wind blows harder. The flower has lost almost all of its petals. It sways and bends away from the wind, but the wind grows stronger and shakes the flower. Once more, the wind shakes the flower, and this time, the flower's seed pods open.
out come many tiny seeds that quickly sail far away on the wind.
The Very Hungry Caterpillar's Rainbow Colors by Eric Carle. The Very Hungry Caterpillar is learning about colors. What colors do you see? I see red, heart, strawberry, fire truck, barn, apple, ladybug. I see orange, cat, orange, goldfish, carrot, yarn, pumpkin. I see yellow, star, duck, cheese, sun, banana, leopard. I see green, frog, leaf, turtle, snake, tree, pear. I see blue, bird, blueberries, whale, kite, book, car. I see purple, plum, candles, grapes, balloons, cupcake, flower. I see the rainbow.
The Very Hungry Caterpillar's First Summer by Eric Carle. Hooray! It's summer. Ready to play? There's so much to explore on a warm, sunny day. Clear blue sky above. Not a cloud in sight. The weather is lovely. The sunshine is just right. It's too hot for jackets and sweaters today. Shorts and t-shirts keep kids cool as they play. The temperature's rising and it's getting hot. Find some shade under trees for a cool resting spot. A gentle breeze blows like a soft lullaby. All is peaceful unless noisy bugs are nearby. Buzz, chirp, click. But these ants march quietly, not making a sound. They smell something tasty. There's food to be found. The lemonade's sour. The ice cream is sweet. And a cold slice of watermelon helps beat the heat. Lunch may be finished, but there's one stop left to make. This day's not complete without a dip in the lake. Splash! Friends meet for a swim, enjoying the sun. Summer is a season
of endless fun. Reading Hugs and Kisses for the Grouchy Ladybug by Eric Carle. Hugs and kisses will make you smile. Clap. Jump for joy. Stand tall. And swing from treetops. You just might strut your stuff. Kick up your heels. Blush. And feel warm and fuzzy. So remember, just like you, even a grouchy ladybug needs hugs and kisses too. Even when you're grouchy, you need hugs and kisses. Make the world a kinder place, one friend at a time. Baby Bear, What Do You See? By Bill Martin Jr. and Eric Carle. Baby Bear, what do you see?
I see a red fox slipping by me.
Red fox, red fox, what do you see?
I see a flying squirrel gliding by me.
Flying squirrel, what do you see?
I see a mountain goat climbing near me.
Mountain goat, what do you see?
I see a blue heron flying by me.
Blue heron, what do you see?
I see a prairie dog digging by me.
Prairie dog, what do you see?
I see a striped skunk strutting by me.
Striped skunk, what do you see?
I see a mole deer running by me.
Mole deer, what do you see?
I see a rattlesnake sliding by me.
Rattlesnake, what do you see?
I see a screech owl hooting at me.
Screech owl, what do you see?
I see a mama bear looking at me.
Mama bear, what do you see?
I see a red fox, a flying squirrel, a mountain goat, a blue heron, a prairie dog, a striped skunk, a mule deer, a rattlesnake, a screech owl, and my baby bear looking at me. That is what I see.
What animal names can you read?
Red fox, flying squirrel, mountain goat, blue heron, prairie dog. Can you match the words to the pictures? Striped skunk. Mole deer. Rattlesnake. Screech owl. What action words can you read? Can you act them out? Slip, glide, climb, fly, dig, strut, run, slide, hoot, look. Where do these animals live? How does each animal move? In the ground, on the ground, in a tree, four legs, two legs, and wings. Thank you very much for joining me today in reading Baby Bear, Baby Bear, What Do You See? If you like this video, please like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.